I used to live in London and had a fantastic job, mostly based about recruitment and training, which was fantastic. I loved that job. I loved everything about that. But in 2008, that November, I halfway up a mountain in Dominican Republic, I had a rupture of a brain aneurysm. It had a very, very strong impact to my life and was going to take several years of rehabilitation. I had to learn how to read and write and remember what things were called, and started to have epilepsy. You know, the impact was very, very strong. But from the life that I used to have to the life that all of a sudden had happened to me, what was there for me, had that, I just didn't know what kind of work I was ever going to be capable of. When I started to consider getting a new job, I found it incredibly hard to find anything that I was going to be able to be capable of, that was something I was going to enjoy or want to do at all. At this point, I started to consider working at home, and I've always loved animals. So coming through the path of trying to consideration, I suddenly thought about dog grooming. And would I want to do dog grooming? Could I do dog grooming? And it's something I was going to be able to work at home and do in my own terms, my own conditions, whatever, you know, is going to work for me. So that I'm going to be capable of doing that job. You have to cover the grounds on absolutely every angle of it. Trying to work out as to how the business is going to set up, you know, things like getting a business plan and, you know, thinking about things like tax and insurance and all of these parts of it, how to start building up clients and, you know, getting the confidence of actually carrying from day one when you open the door. For me as well, like how much energy am I going to have to be able to do so many dogs in one day, or is it going to work on that? But it's constantly trying to test and see how it's always going to work for me. You have to know that it's something you're going to love, that's something that's going to keep you well motivated. What worked for me the best was the fact that I am working at home, it's on my own terms, and it is something that I really love to do. You need support, and as many levels of support you can actually get. Through all my rehabilitation, I've had contacts with people through the brain injury team. You then get somewhere like the Cedar Foundation, who've been there side by side to help me to consider as to how this all gets done. And from there, you're able to expand where all the support is from so many different angles. Having spent 6 months test training through the job centre, at that time I really understood that I was not going to be able to do it for a full-time job. It really showed me that I have limits as to how much I can actually deal with. So at the end of the test training, I was able to change it into permitted work, which is there to allow you to take up to 16 hours in the week. And that means that I've got the support to be able to develop, and, you know, to see from there. And over a bit of time, as things develop, I might have the opportunity to step it up from there. For anybody with any form of disability who's considering about having their own business, you're going to need friends, family, every kind of support that you can get from every angle that's going to be there to help you through all of this. If you're determined, there's a way of doing it, and you've got every opportunity to be able to do it. Now I've gone through all of the steps to come through this, I'm always so happy that this is the kind of job that I have got. When you wake up in the morning, you want to get up. You want to go and see what dog's coming today, look at the list and see what's coming, who I'm going to be doing the work with. All of those things, it makes a difference. There are days when you go, why do I think I can do this? But you just keep the focus going on it, and if it's something you really want, you just keep going forward.